Hello, beloved. You are welcome back to the Way of Salvation program. And I believe the messages are helping you become aware of demons so that you don't become a victim. All that I'm trying to do is to make you aware of demonic activity so that you don't fall into their traps. Simple. I want you to develop a holy anger for demons because they also don't like you. As I've been building up, I've been saying they do not like human beings for the simple reason that God loves you. You can change your mind. You can repent and serve the living God, but they can't. They cannot change their mind. They cannot be to be in heaven. They cannot be in heaven anymore. It is finished for them. But God loves you. When he spoke to Adam and Eve in the kingdom, he gave them power over demons. And God has given us access to come to his presence and live with them forever. Demons don't have that. That is why they don't like you. So I also want you to develop a holy anger for them so that you don't become a victim. That is all that I'm trying to do. Thank God for another day. Today, pastors are not talking about demons. And I proved to you from the scriptures that we have to be doing that, but we are not doing that. I said the Lord Jesus sent us to go and cast out demons. So we should be doing that. That is where I left off last time. And today, I still want to answer that question. Why are pastors not talking about demons? Three reasons. First one, if you are not talking about demons, the first answer is that, or the first reason is that, Jesus has not called you. Pastors are not talking about demons. The first reason could be that they are not called. Because not all men of God are of God. Those who are not called don't touch on very important subjects which will help people to go to heaven. That's the first reason. The second reason is that if pastors are not talking about demons, it means he has a missed call. Many of the pastors have missed calling. What do I mean by that? Jesus truly called them, but along the line, they missed the call. They got frustrated and changed their way of life. Some of them started very well. They started very good. But along the line, they shifted and went for prosperity messages. That is why they are not talking about demons. They have shifted. They have missed their calling. That's the second reason. The third reason is very important. It is because they don't understand the great commission of Matthew chapter 10 verse 8, in which the Lord said we should cast out demons. So for you to cast out, the people should know about them. You should be preaching about them so that you can cast them out from the people. So these are the three reasons. Other reasons: either you are not called, or you have a missed call, or you don't understand the Great Commission. Simply put, these are the three reasons. You see, these are the three reasons. If you don't understand as a pastor that you have a divine mandate, divine duty to cast out demons, you won't be talking about it. If you understand that you have a divine calling. And the Lord Jesus said, we should cast out demons because they are the enemies who are preventing people from entering the kingdom. That is why he said, when we preach about the kingdom, we should set people who will come to him with demons free. That is the reason. We have to set people free from demons. If you are casting out demons from, let me say it this way. If you don't cast out demons from people and teach them how to enter, it will be very, very difficult if even you speak to them and they come to church. If they come to church and you don't cast out the demons from them and teach them how to enter, it will be difficult. So the pastors are not talking about demons because of these reasons. Because of that. So you have to understand that preaching about the kingdom of God should be synonymous with casting out demons. It goes hand in hand. That's why the Lord said, when you go, preach about the kingdom. After preaching about the kingdom, surely some people will come to believe. And when they do, it is the duty of the man of God. It is my duty to set the captive free. Simple. That is how it should be. When you go, tell them about me. And when they believe me, drive the enemy away from them. Simple. Simple. So I don't understand why some men of God don't get this. This is the real task of a pastor. You are supposed to drive the enemy from the people, whether you like it or not. We have only two people in this world. Only two people. Two. We have God and demons. And when we come to human beings, we have for God and against God. There are no in-betweens. You cannot say, I don't believe in God. I also don't believe in demons. You can't say that. You either believe in God or you believe in demons. There are no non-allies. So there are only two people. So when they come to Jesus, that is why I was saying the other day that if you are not on the side of God, then automatically you are on their side. So when the people who are on the side of demons, who are on the side of the enemy, when they come to believe the gospel, then it is the duty of the representative of God on earth, who is the pastor, to set the person free from the demonic activity. Else the enemy will still harass him. He will still be inside to disturb the human being. That is simply the duty of the pastor. If you don't do that, all that you are doing will be fruitless. Because they will still live in sin. The people who struggle with sin all the time. So get this understanding. Now, as I continue, let's listen to what the Lord said again. Talking about the preaching about the kingdom, how to enter the kingdom of God, and then demons. Let's hear what the Lord said from Matthew chapter 12, verse 28. But if I cast out demons by the Spirit of God, surely the kingdom of God has come upon you. Let me repeat. But if I cast out demons by the Spirit of God, surely the kingdom of God has come upon you. Casting out demons will make people experience the kingdom of heaven. Because if you don't do that, they will still be connected with the demonic activity in their lives. And they will not know and feel the joy of heaven. From the mindset to the toes of their feet, they will still be experiencing the same same lifestyle in the world. But if you cast out the demons from them, then the joy of his presence, the joy of the Holy Spirit becomes relevant to them. They will experience it personally. That is what the Lord meant. If I cast out demons from people, then he says, surely the kingdom of God is in you. So that is the meaning. Let us cast out demons for the people to taste heaven on earth. Let them enjoy heaven in their bodies. Amen. That is how it will be. Now, if we don't do that, we will still let the demons hold them captive, and that will be counterproductive. We should always do that. They will struggle with holiness. People will struggle. When I say our emphasis is on holiness, I have set the people in this church free so they can flow and do the things that are required of them by God. But if you don't do that, the church people always struggle with sin. That is why I say, if your emphasis is on the kingdom, then cast out the demons so that they can freely serve the Lord in Jesus' name. That is how it should be. Now, all that I'm talking about, go tell the people about the kingdom. And when they come, cast out the enemy from them. It has got nothing to do with money. It has got nothing to do with money. That is the problem of today's church. That is why I was trying to disagree with the 1, 2, 3, sow a seed sermons. If I'm bringing somebody into the kingdom, then I'll go and say, hey, give me some money, sow some seed there. Don't you see God will be angry with you? Don't you see that? Because go and bring somebody into my kingdom has got nothing to do with money. You just go and say it. So if you are called by God, do the work of the kingdom. Do the work of the kingdom. The work, actual work of the kingdom is to first tell them about Jesus, the eternal Lord who will reign forever and ever and ever, where there will be no more death. If you say that and they believe you, cast out the demons. It is not only about words. We have divine mandate. If he has truly called you, if God called you, as you say, he will give you power. He never calls anyone and gives you an empty hand. This hand has power. God has endowed me with power. I see power every day when I pray for people. That is the calling. It is not about talking. It is not about words. If you speak. They are enticing words. If you entice the people and they come and sit in the church and they are still tormented by demons, you have done nothing. If you are talking about money without doing this, I'm sorry for you. It has got nothing to do with money. Set the captives free first and please the Lord. My intention is to set people free and bring them to God. I want to please my Lord. So that is the ministry. That is what the Lord wants us to do. Now, if people are, the reason why people are committing suicide in the church, I'll handle these things. You take your time. I am building the messages small. I'll handle them for you so that you understand. You get a very deep understanding about demons. Why are people, church people, why are they committing suicide? There was a story I heard that a pastor was in his church the Saturday evening. He prepared the Sunday school teachers. He was a pastor in charge. The next morning, it was Easter Sunday. Very, very important day of the Christian church. When they got to the church, the pastor was hanging on the ceiling. He committed suicide. Very sad story. What went wrong? What went wrong? That for a pastor to have a suicidal demon inside him. Why? These are some of the things I'm talking about. So please, we need to understand these things. If demons are tormenting you, because he gave me the power to set captives free, I am telling you, come to believe in Jesus, and I will pray for you free of charge. If even Lucifer, I don't know, for him he is even a small boy. From what I know, Lucifer is small. If even Lucifer is in your body, come to believe in Jesus, and I will cast him out from your body free of charge in Jesus' name. That is what he called me to do, to set captives free. I don't need your money. I need your salvation. I need your heart. Amen. So the summary of what I've said so far, before I continue, is that the Lord wants us to preach about the kingdom. When I finish preaching about the need for them to enter the kingdom and they come, he wants me as his representative on earth to cast out the enemy from the person's life. When that happens, then the person has experienced heaven on earth. Simple. Go and preach about the kingdom. Those that believe in me, cast my enemy out from them. And when you do that, they will experience my kingdom. Hallelujah. That is simple. That is simple. So the first question is answered. The first question as to why are pastors not talking about demons is answered. Okay. Now let me continue with another question. Is it good to talk about demons in the church? That is another question. Is it good to talk about demons in the church? It is very funny that many Christians, so-called Christians, when they hear the word demon, they are so much afraid and frightened. You get my book. What I'm sharing with you here is not in the book. There are deeper things I've talked about in my book. So get the book. You get a deeper understanding. There are many people, when they hear the word demon, they are so much frightened and they don't want to hear anything about it. Even Christians. But our Lord Jesus was the one who said, we should cast out demons. So why are you afraid? Eh? Why? Please, for me to continue, before I continue, take the dread, take the fear of demons away from your life. Take the fear of demons away from your life. You cannot ignore the subject of demonology. You can't ignore them. It is part of the Bible. It is part and parcel of the kingdom. If you want to enter the kingdom, the Lord said we should cast. That means demons can prevent you from entering. If someone can prevent you, we need to hear about them. So let me continue to address the question as to why, as to whether it is good to talk about demons in the church. The first thing to talk about is that, yes, it is good to talk about demons, to inform the church about. It is very good, so that they will know what is opposing them. They will know their enemy. That is the first reason. It is good to talk about demons. If you are a pastor and you are running away from that, it is wrong. It is good to talk about them. I said you may not become. That is the first thing. First, we need to talk about demons. Number two, why are we supposed to talk about demons in the church? The answer is that they are your enemies. They are your opponents. They are opposing God. And I told you, they don't want anybody to be with God. They have sworn by their blood. They said, we will never go into the hellfire alone or only. We will not be the only ones to be in the hellfire. We will drag these people along with us. That is what they have said. If you don't know, I'm telling you. They have said, we will drag people along with us. I will never go to hell. I don't want to hear the word hell. If you don't want to go to hell, then hear about demons. Because they are the ones opposing you. They are the ones who block you. They are your enemies. You need to know your enemy. You see, they are your enemies. Not because you have offended them, but it is just for the simple reason that, as I told you earlier, that you can repent and go to heaven where they have been driven away from. I said the other time that if you are going to a village and somebody has been banished from that village, you will feel jealous that you can go in. So he will not give you proper directions. Another analogy is that if a house help or somebody stayed in a house or a palace, somebody stayed in a palace and the person has been driven away, and you see that person and say, oh, can you please show me the directions or and show me the way to be in the palace? Don't you see the person will be jealous of you and will not let you go in? That's exactly what they are doing. They have been kicked out of heaven. They don't have that access anymore. And God said, you can come in. That is the jealousy. So you need to hear about your opponent. That is the second reason. When you hear about them, you know where to place your feet. The third reason is that we need to know about demons in the church. It is just like a very good coach of a football team. I was a footballer myself. But listen, every good coach will always learn the tactics of the opposing team. We will sit down in the room with the blackboard. Today the players can have videos about the opposing team, then you discuss about them. A very good coach will do this. You see, have you seen the opponent? Have you seen how they play? Have you seen their formation? Okay, we are also going with this style. I want you to eliminate this player from the team. You have to play like this, play like that. You see, that is a good coach. If somebody is a good coach, he will show you the tactics. He will show the players the tactics of the opponent. In the same way, if a pastor is a good one, he will be talking about demons and the enemy, because he is the one blocking the people from serving God correctly. Imagine if there is no demon in this world, everybody will serve God. Because they are here with us, that is why the Lord said we should cast them away from the people for them to serve him correctly. So it is good. The first analogy is about the coach and his players. You'll be informing the players about the opposing team, how to play and eliminate the dangerous players. The second analogy I do always is about the military general. If you are leading your people to war, you find out their war tactics. You find out the weapons they use in order to counteract their actions. You plan your next line of action according to the way that you know. You see? So if you are called by God, you need to talk about Jesus. Sorry, you need to talk about demons. If you are a true man or a woman who wants to enter the kingdom of God, then it is good to let you know more about demons. It is funny that today we have neglected this important subject. You see, the Lord sent me to you. This is so important. That is why he told me, go and tell them about demons. If you can be free from demons, entering the kingdom and living holy and entering the kingdom will be easy. If you are free from demons, you can live holy and enter the kingdom of heaven. That is how it should be. So the question to whether it is good to talk about demons in the church is also answered. Now, why are pastors not doing this? I've addressed that already. So please, be very much alarmed. Be very much alarmed as someone wants to enter the kingdom of God. If your church, if the pastor in charge is not informing you about the opponent, and he's only talking about, I see God blessing you. I see God lifting you up. I see God giving you the anointing to accelerate in life. This is funny. That those preachings are funny. That is what the Bible calls enticing words. If demons are in your life, you always struggle to please the Almighty God. Do your best. Do your best. So that you sit in the church, that you hear the tactics of the enemy, of the opponent, so that you can know how to go ahead. This is the true responsibility of the pastor who is called by God. So let me take my time to also address the role of a pastor. You can understand from my analysis and from the scriptures I've been using that the pastor, you see, the fivefold ministers, the apostle, the evangelist, the prophet, the teacher, and the pastor. These are the fivefold ministers. All of them are called by God. And if God calls you, he will equip you to make the people free. The most important of them is the pastor, because you are the day-to-day man. You are the shepherd of the sheep. You live with them all the time. Thank God I have all the five gifts. I operate in all the five. All the people who know me will tell you, I operate in all the five. But the most important one is the pastor, because you are like the father and the children at home. You have to feed them every day. So if you are staying with your children and there are some enemies around, are you telling me you will not inform your children to be careful? You tell them, you will. You tell them to be very careful so that they will not fall into the hands of evil men. Simply that. Simply that. So it is wrong to be in a church where they are talking about prosperity all the time. It is big deception. Whereas the sin is hidden. There are some churches, if you belong to them, you can never repent because of the messages that comes out from the pulpit. You see? So this is the duty of a pastor. You are called by God to take care of God's people so that the enemy will not touch them. Let me continue next time. Wait for the next part. I will be talking more about demons and the role of a pastor. And don't forget, I've been telling you, the Lord God called me. I've been doing this for over 30 years. And I have power over them. I don't care the demon that is in you. I don't care. You come to give your life to Jesus, and I will help you if you are willing. I don't want you to come and solve problems. Today, people are only going to churches to solve problems. I come with my sickness. Heal me and let me go away. I'm not looking for such people. If you want to believe in Jesus and live your life for him, then every demon that is inside you, I'll cast out free of charge. Believe in Jesus today if you don't have him in your life. I'll see you next time, and I'll tell you more about these things. Tell your friends about this program, about the Way of Salvation program, that are making you aware of certain things that can block you from entering the kingdom. Jesus is coming soon. I love you. I don't want you to go to hell. That is why he sent me to you. Give your life to Jesus now, and you'll live forever. God bless you. I'll see you again. Bye-bye.
Thank you for watching this video. I really hope you have been enlightened. To hear more, you may subscribe to this channel and click the notification bell to see more videos. Pastor Kukudatsi has written a very informative book called How Demons Operate. Grab yourself a copy to know how they operate and know how to liberate yourself from demonic oppression. To stay in contact with us, you can reach us through these details. God bless you.